But personal growth does not just stop at self-care. So much of personal growth is the pain and the hard work and the wanting to be better and wanting to make better choices, that you shove away the instant gratification, that you shove away what would be easy to do for something that makes you better.
So the self-care movement has recently been hijacked by Instagram into basically meaning luxury baths with Lush products, or ordering room service, or just finding other ways of treating yourself more than you normally would. And that in itself is not an issue. But the part that I have a problem with is when self-care is considered the full extent of personal growth. But I'm here to tell you that baths and massages won't bring you inner peace or really help you reach your goals.
So, you know, sometimes you do need a break, but the problem is when it stops at the break. You know, yes, you can take a nice bath. Yes, you can take some time to watch TV. But the problem is when it just stops there. And so a lot of the time, you know, you conflate self-help or personal growth with the idea of self-care. And of course, self-care is a big part of it. But personal growth does not just stop at self-care. You can't just take a little bit of care of yourself and say, oh my God, look at me on this like personal growth journey. I'm doing so much. You're really not. It's so much more than that. And so much of personal growth is the pain and the hard work and the wanting to be better and wanting to make better choices, that you shove away the instant gratification, that you shove away what would be easy to do for something that makes you better. You don't want to be in the position where when you get mentally tired, emotionally tired, physically tired, spiritually tired, that you are then going to retreat. That is when you grow. Those times when you are being tested and when you are being challenged, that is when you absolutely flourish. And that's when you can prove to yourself how much you've changed, how much you've grown. That's when you're given the opportunity to choose a different path, to make a different choice for. So it's really, really important in that time that you don't just say, oh, I'm going to give myself a break. Oh, I'm being tried. I'm being tested. I'm being pushed. So I'm just going to take a step back and, you know, watch Netflix because it's my time for self-care. No, when you have those moments where you're being tested and you're being tried and, you know, people are asking things of you, you better step up to the plate. You better, you know, take that opportunity. You better rise to that occasion, because you're never going to grow or develop if you don't have another chance to prove yourself wrong, or to prove other people wrong, or to show that you really can, you know, put yourself out there. So I wanted to bring up this idea of self-parenting, right? So you may have heard of this, you may not have, but it's pretty much the idea of talking to yourself like a parent would, right? So you may have also heard of the idea of the inner child of us, you know, who we were when we were born, when we were just a few years old, when we were 8 years old, 10 years old, that person is still inside of us. There's so many parts of a child, of your childhood, that are still carried with you, whether those parts are good or bad. And so along those same lines of you having an inner child and being able to connect to that inner spirit, you also have an inner parent. And so the inner child, you know, has qualities like, you know, the inner child can be traumatized. The inner child can be shy. They can have a lot of self-doubt. They can be worried, flustered, lacking in confidence. Whereas the inner parent is reasonable, the inner parent is rational, they're focused, they're looking forward to certain goals, they're making sure that you're on task, they're making sure that you're doing the right thing for you. They're thinking long term, and the inner child is thinking short term. When you're a good caretaker, you know, you are empathetic, you are understanding, you are encouraging of whoever you're taking care of, right? And we all know that we can be our worst critics. The way that you would talk to yourself is probably not how you would talk to your loved ones, you know? So you really need to take on that mentality of being a caretaker, of saying, I'm taking care of you. I'm taking your burdens and putting them on my back. I'm going to fight for you. The way that you would fight for your kids, you're going to have to teach yourself how you can do that for yourself, for your own inner child. And another thing that I want to mention is, you know, with parents, it can be a sensitive topic. Maybe you are a sweet, nurturing person, but maybe you didn't have that from your parents. Maybe your parents didn't talk to you in a nice way, in an encouraging way, in an empathetic way. Maybe they were really, really harsh at you. Maybe they cursed at you. Maybe they talked down to you constantly. Maybe they were abusive in their words and in kind of the way that they dealt with their emotions and your own. And so this is an amazing opportunity, an amazing time for you to kind of rebirth that inner voice that you have. Because what a lot of people don't talk about is that your inner voice comes from your parents. So if your parents were, you know, cursing at themselves or cursing at you, other people in your family, if there was a lot of tension and anger and bitterness, you're going to have that when you're talking to yourself in your normal day-to-day thoughts, in the things that come up in your mind. You're going to have a lot of ideas of, you know, being that way, being angry and being bitter and being irrational and wanting to jump to conclusions. You're going to feel that way in yourself. So this is an incredible way to heal, you know, those generational patterns of how you talk to yourself, how you use language, how you deal with your attitude, how you deal with anger. A lot of those things can really be reprocessed by self-parenting. And where self-parenting differs from self-care is that, again, it's long-term thinking. It's thinking about what really is the best for you. It's looking at your goals and saying, okay, how can I make my dream life my reality? So with self-parenting, you're, you know, if you're trying to lose weight and that's your goal, you could have the little cravings and the little indulgences of wanting dessert or of wanting dairy or whatever it is that you're trying to stay away from. But if you're in the self-care mentality, you could say, you know what, treat yourself. That chocolate cake isn't going to kill you. And you know what, it's not. But if your goal is, you know, to eat healthier, to take better care of yourself, for your body to function better, for you to not be so tired, for you to, you know, be on point at your next workout, then maybe what you need to do is, you know, find a different dessert you can make, find, you know, from some fruit you can eat or a different alternative. Find something that you can do, that you can work within those guidelines where, yes, you're taking care of yourself and you're maybe giving into a bit of an indulgence or something, but you have your end goal in mind. You have that goal. You're parenting yourself and saying, no, not right now. You're going to do that later. You're going to hit this goal first, and then we can see, you know, how we want to move on from there. And this another example is spending money. Yeah, it would feel great, you know, to buy a new outfit or to, you know, look great or to splurge a little bit. And in that self-care mentality, you would say, you know, do it. Spend $50 every weekend on going out to brunch or going out for a couple of drinks. You know, spend that money and do this and that. But then on the other side of it, that self-parenting side would tell you, you know what, your goal is to save up for, you know, for a new car. Your goal is to save up for that down payment on that house. Whatever your goals are, you need to say, is, you know, spending $50 every weekend going to be worth it at the end of the day? Or do I need to parent myself and discipline myself and tell myself that I'm going to manage and I'm going to be just fine because I have this bigger thing on my mind? My mind is on a different dimension. It's on a different plane. And I have all these goals that I'm going to set for myself that I need to reach. And I'm not going to allow myself to stumble from that path. I'm not going to allow myself to give in to all these little things. I'm going to allow myself to stay tested, to be pushed, to be tried, and I'm going to stick it through with integrity, with my goal in mind, with what I came here to do. I'm going to finish strong. And you have to have that mentality because that's what's going to take you so much further than just self-care. You need to self-parent. Yes, you need to balance both, but at the end of the day, you need to look at your goals and look at your dream life and say, you know, what do I really want in life? And it takes time to figure that out, but you know, you might know one piece of the puzzle. Maybe you know you want to be a parent. Maybe you know you want to be married. Maybe you know you want to have this kind of job. Or maybe you know you want to be an artist. Whatever it is that you know, take that one little piece, and make that a non-negotiable goal. And that is going to be your number one thing from right now. And slowly together, as time goes on and as things evolve, you'll figure out what else you want from life and who else you want you to be in your life and what you don't want from life. That's a huge part in what you're figuring out as well. So you need to figure all these things out, and then on top of that, balance self-care and self-parenting. So I say no to so many things because I prioritize taking time to take care of myself. I prioritize having time to just chill out a little bit and not put pressure on myself. But I also use the rest of the time to work on my business, to do my actual work, to make sure I'm on top of my financial goals, my fitness goals. There's so many other things that I want to do in my life, and I prioritize my entire life around those goals. And I'm telling you, if I couldn't even imagine that this would be my life a year or two ago, you know? And I feel like I'm on a different level of believing in myself and knowing that I can trust myself and honor myself in doing the things that I'm setting out to do, because I've proven that to myself over and over and over again. And no one can take that confidence away from me, you know? No one can take that belief in myself away. And that's what I want you to have. Alright y'all, well I want to thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that this inspired you to discipline yourself and to be strong and to hang in there, because you can reach those goals that you've set for yourself and you can do so much more than you ever, ever thought you could do. So with some discipline and some hard work and some belief in yourself, you will honestly get there. And I hope that this video inspired you to believe that. If you want to check out other videos, I will link them here. Thank you all so, so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure you like and hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell. It really means the world to me and it supports my channel so much. I will see you next week. Happy healing.